I was in the Naval Reserve, and the Army was out of doctors. And so they said, Foley, you're now in the Army. So they sent me to Korea with the Army, even though I was in the Navy. They loaned me to the Army. Before, on the way to Korea, you go to Hawaii, and then Wake Island, and then Japan, I guess. Yeah, we landed in Hawaii, and the guy said, you know, you got a few hours. So we rushed down and bought bathing suits and went to Waikiki Beach, went swimming, and then we rushed back, got a taxi. There was three or four of us. We got a taxi back to the airbase, and we were too late. Plane was gone. We're AWOL. Then we found out that the time had changed, that there was some trouble with the engine. So we got back in the taxi and went back to Waikiki Beach. That was kind of scary, though, when we thought we were AWOL. And then it was a couple days in Japan before I went into Korea. Went to a geisha house. But a geisha house is not a whorehouse. It's these gals all dressed up, and they tippy-toe in, you know, all made up. And you'd sit squatting at a table on the floor almost, and they'd serve you sake. And I suppose if you wanted to, you could take them home, but we didn't do it. We just went to see what a geisha house was like. So I ended up in Korea in a clearing station. Well, the first one is a battalion aide, where you're out there and you pick up the wounded, and somehow they get back to us, clearing station. And we do what we could for them, and then we call the choppers in and put them on the choppers, and then they'd fly them back to the MASH unit, I guess. You ever hear the Chosin Reservoir, where the Marines were beat up when the Chinese came into the war? Well, we landed up in North Korea just as the Marines were staggering down from the Chosin Reservoir. And that's where I spent the first couple of weeks up in North Korea. I was scared to death, I suppose, because all the Marines were leaving and I was going in. That didn't seem very bright idea to me. The Marines are going and we're coming. But we were only there a few weeks. Whew, the first night, I slept in a tent with a wooden floor, and all I had was my overcoat, and it was 25 degrees below zero. Oh, it was cold. Across the valley, we could see the mountains. And up in the mountains, we used to watch the U.S. planes come down and napalm the Chinese who were up in the mountains just above us. And we always used to bet whether the guy was married or single, depending how low he went before he dropped his napalm. That was quite a scene. And then the Chinese got too close, and then we got aboard a ship and went down to the bottom of Korea. We were the last people off the shore in North Korea on Christmas Day. Well, they blew up all the ammunition. It was all the stuff that was left there from the American troops. It was fabulous. I was on a battleship at the time going down to Busan, the bottom of Korea. Yeah, they were an interesting group of people I was with in the clearing company. When we first, you know, we went down to Busan after we left North Korea, and then we went all the way back up to Seoul. And our captain always looked for the best places to set up our hospital light. So the first night we were in this school, the generator is going like crazy. And the captain said, that generator shouldn't be going. Foley, come along. So we went out to find out what was happening. And the guys had started the generator. He said, what the hell is happening? So we started following the line, and you know where it ended up? In the local whorehouse. They'd wired the local whorehouse for electricity the first night we were in there. Boy, they were a great bunch. One time when there was a big battle, and we were receiving patients, and the British, I think, are the best soldiers in the world. And this guy walked in, and he's holding his hands across his belly like this. And I said, let me help you. He moved his hands away and his whole guts just rolled out. It was horrible. The British were really something.